Hello, and welcome to your astrological vibrations for Saturday, November 14th, 2015, by Gaia Blooming. I am Mimi, and our energy mantra for today is I transform and break through to my highest potential. And today we have like the day kind of in two parts. I think before Capricorn Moon, after Capricorn Moon. So most of the day it actually has the Sagittarius Moon void, of course. So it may be kind of a catter day, kind of more of a sleepy Saturday. But actually, this is a great call to go within, do some of that breakthrough stuff. We are in the third revolution, evolution day of Sun in Scorpio, the last one. So those are Uranus ruled days where stuff may come up that we have to process through, evolve through. I mean, that's ultimately, the goal of Uranus is to help you evolve, reach your highest vibration. But sometimes it takes those triggers that we have to break through. So we're getting there. And the third one, you know, it's so interesting. The first and second ones can be kind of juicy. So the third one usually is like, okay, I really can implement some of those other lessons that triggered me before. But I think aiding in this trigger, aiding in your processing, kind of think this is actually cool. We're going to have Venus, which is in Libra, in conjunct Neptune in Pisces. And Neptune is retrograde in Pisces for just a few more days. And so what I'm feeling, you know, Neptune in Pisces has really been helping us work through old karmic stuff, or retrograde in Pisces, old karma stuff, old stuff that it's time to let go of. And this connection to Venus may be connecting you to old relationship stuff, whether it's old relationship stuff with your family, co-workers, past relationships, friendships, whatever, but it's helping you work through some of this old stuff that's still affecting your vibration, still affecting your relationship resonance. Who are you carrying into your life? So that morning, void of course moon, you know, Sagittarius wants to explore and be open. Be open to this stuff coming up. I've had a lot of people, me included, have a lot of old relationship stuff, but this stuff comes up to be worked through. So this is a beneficial thing. So take that time. Oh, Lala says hi. And so then we have the moon shifting into Capricorn. And Capricorn, I really do like Capricorn as the energy of responsibility. How are you responding to things that show up in your life? And this moon is actually going to be squaring Mars in Libra. So there's Libra action today. And what came up for this is, you know, with Mars and Libra, we're working on allowing our desires to catch on passion, if that makes sense, to catch on fire, to be pulling us into that I am resonance. But the moon in Capricorn can be kind of practical. It might be like, hey, that's not a practical plan. And it might not be. But what it's so funny because as I was like, you know, sitting with the astro, looking to see what came up, my Facebook memories from a few years ago came up, and there was a meme that I had shared from Mama Gina, who is all about pleasure and desire, and said, it takes way more responsibility to enjoy your life than it does to complain about it. And so, this is your responsibility to find a way to allow your desires, to allow your pleasure to move forward in your life. And I want to remind you of the Osho card, Zorba the Buddha, his abundance card, which is saying, hey, you have your spiritual life, and that's wonderful. You also have to make a life, an enjoyable life, here on this earth. That's why you're here. So we're working through that today. We're working through that responsibility and making breakthroughs, because this is all part of the highest potential. So the cards that I pulled, I couldn't believe it. When I turned over the cards, I was like, really? This is the first card I pulled. Breakthrough. We are breaking through, and we're tapping into the heart and allowing that energy to transform us. And we're doing that today. You know, this is like, I could break my cards into two parts too. We're breaking through this by slowing down and getting in touch with the innocence within, the part of you that believes, the light in you that's pulling you into that bright future, and tapping into the infinite possibilities, recognizing that this is everything and nothing. This is the no-thingness card. And this card is saying infinite possibilities are available to you. So this is like the first part of the day. This is before Capricorn Moon and then after Capricorn Moon. And I was like, seriously? abundance, and the master. To get here where you are Zorba the Buddha, enjoying your spiritual self and enjoying your physical self, enjoying the fruits of the earth, the sensuality of the earth, you have to master yourself. It takes way more responsibility to enjoy your life than it does to complain about it. So step into your mastery so you can step into your highest potential. And from the wild unknown, the Sun of Wands. Be charmed into your desire. Be charmed into your creativity. Let what you love silently draw you in that direction. It won't lead you astray. That's like a Rumi. That's a Mimi-ized Rumi passage. Anyways, that's it for today. But go book a reading. Purchase a birth chart. Let me express my creativity. And I will see you tomorrow. Have a beautiful Saturday. Namaste.